Up next is SMU head coach Sonny Dykes. The Mustangs are 6-0 overall, 2-0 in the American Athletic Conference. SMU was idle last week. They're back in action Saturday against Temple at Gerald J. Ford Stadium in Dallas, 3:30 Eastern, 2:30 Central on ESPN2. Coach, thanks so much for joining us on the call. If we just get your thoughts on the state of the Mustangs as you head into the what's now a top 25 matchup at Ford Stadium Saturday.
Yeah, looking forward to you know, having a chance to get back out there and play against a really good Temple team. Was really impressed with the way they, you know, won that game Saturday against Memphis. Thought they played really hard, you know, played physical, made some plays when they needed to. We needed an open date. We had kind of an emotional game the week before against Tulsa, and so I think the off week came at a good time for us. Had a chance to heal up a little bit, you know, had some really good practices. Gave our guys a little bit of time off to try to get away and spend some time on academics and get rested up. We kind of started on Temple yesterday and had a good practice. So looking forward to getting back out there and competing against a really good football team.
Any questions for Coach Sonny Dykes, please? Star 1 on your telephone keypad will put you in the queue, and then the operator will introduce you.
First is Dan Totoro with WakeUpCallDT.com.
Good morning, Coach. How are you?
Great, thanks. How are you doing?
Doing well, thanks for asking. Obviously looking at where this program is at, I know you're early on in your coaching tenure at SMU, 6-0 start for the first time in over 35 years. Just what that feels like for you from your seat and just what you can say about the fan base.
Well, I mean, I've been encouraged. You know, I think that, when you take a job, there's a lot of moving parts and you have to get everybody aligned. And I think that's been the most impressive thing about being at SMU is just the fact that, you know, that there's great alignment from our president to our athletic director. Everybody has a vision for what they want to do and how they want to do it. And that gives you a chance when you have that. I mean, it's really hard to win in college football. And you have to have everybody on the same page and pull in the same way. And the great thing is we have that here, and that gives us an opportunity when you have that. And not every program is that way. As a matter of fact, most aren't. And so I'm really fortunate to be here at a great university and a great city. And, you know, I love our players. You know, the guys have done a great job of buying into what we've asked them to do. You know, every time we ask them to do something, they've done it. And they've done it to the best of their ability. So it's been fun so far. I think you said it. We're just, you know, it's early in the season and we're getting ready to hit the meat of our schedule, and we know that. This conference is really strong from top to bottom. You better play well every single week or you're going to get beat. So we're not looking ahead to anything. You know, we're just trying to get better every day and make sure that we prepare for Temple. But, you know, we're excited. I think our fan base is excited and energized, and I think they see the potential, you know, for this program, you know, not only this year but moving forward.
And you've had an offense this season so far that's scored over 40 points in 5 of your games, 37 in the other. Just what you can say about the depth of your skill players as well as your quarterback, just what this offense has been able to put forward this season so far.
Well, I think the big thing is we've been fairly consistent. We've gotten off to pretty good starts, with the exception of the Tulsa game. But, you know, we've come out pretty fast and we've had some success early. And I think that we're, you know, playing with a lot of confidence. I think our players feel like that, you know, they like our scheme and they're comfortable with it. And, you know, our quarterback play has been very solid and we've got some big play wide receivers and, you know, our running back is playing really well. Our offensive line has progressed, I think, probably better than we anticipated. And so, you know, all those things are kind of fitting together and it's been good to see. We can certainly play a lot better than we have. I mean, that's the good thing is I don't think we've walked off the field, you know, at any point this year and said, wow, you know, we played great. We played great. I think we've all, you know, I think collectively coaches, players, everybody has said, yeah, you know, we did some good things, but we can certainly do things a lot better than we have. And so, you know, I like the group. It's a competitive group. They want to be good. They listen, they like each other and they enjoy playing together.
Well, thank you, Coach, and good luck moving forward.
Okay, thank you.
We'll go to Stephen Hawkins with the Associated Press.
Morning, Sonny. You said a minute ago, obviously, you kind of the break came at a good time. What do you think you learned about your team during this time, you know, having basically midway through the regular season now?
Well, I think, you know, I think that, you know, we've had to win some football games different ways. You know, we've had to get some defensive stops at the end of games. You know, we did that against TCU where we had to stop and they had a chance to win the game. And then we've had to win some games, you know, offensively, and we've had to do some things to give ourselves a chance to beat good teams. And I think that's been the thing I've been most encouraged with is that, you know, when our defenses had to step up, they stepped up. And when our offenses had to step up and make some plays, they've done that. You know, they've played well together. You know, I think they feed off of each other when we're getting a bunch of stops. Everybody still there?
Yep, Coach.
Okay. Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, Coach. Yeah, we can move on to the next question, please.
Okay.
We'll go to Damon Sells with Rivals.com.
Hey, good morning, Coach. How you doing?
Great, thanks.
So you're looking at the schedule here, and you've got a lot of teams with one loss in the bottom half of this season here. And you kind of touched on this earlier, but do you look at the rest of this schedule as a gauntlet of sorts for this team? I know you guys are on a 1-0 season each and every week, but do you look at the schedule as a gauntlet of sorts?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard not to look at it and you know, all the way through and say, wow, we're going to play a lot of good football teams and a bunch of teams that, you know, have had a lot of success. The one thing that's getting ready to happen with our league is kind of what happened last week, where you've got, you know, two really good teams playing each other in Temple and Memphis, and somebody has to win. And you know, teams are going to start knocking each other off in the league. There's a lot of really, really good football teams, you know, a lot of good one-loss teams that have, you know, quality wins against Power 5 teams and just really, you know, dominating performances against some good football teams. And so I think the league is very, very solid. I think when you compare us to some of the other Power 5 leagues, you know, we compare very favorably. I think, you know, just a casual fan, I think, can see that. I think if you dig into it and really take a look at it, I think it's really impressive, you know, what the teams in this league have done. And again, I think there's just great depth from top to bottom and really a great brand of football that's being played. And again, when you look at the teams physically, you know, the size and strength and speed, you know, just like the Temple, when you look at them physically, you know, they match up against pretty much anybody in the country. And so, you know, we're going to have our hands full. As you said, we look at it as a just, you know, prepare for one game a week and don't worry about anything but trying to play well and prepare well on Saturday. And that's kind of what our mantra has been from the very beginning. But I do have a tremendous respect for the league and where these teams are. And you know, the coaching's outstanding, and there's a lot of really good football players in the league.
As a quick follow-up, you know, we saw Reggie Roberson get dinged up in the Tulsa game. Can you just kind of give a quick update as to how he's doing?
Yeah, he practiced last night, and he's good to go for Saturday.
Good deal. Thanks, Sonny.
Okay, thank you.
Take one more.
We'll go to Sean Pester with Owls Daily.
Hey.
Hi, how you doing?
You know, with Brett, great. With Brett Dearson going to Temple, and particularly the timing, I wonder if that has an impact, you know, logistically on calls and signals and things like that this week.
Well, yes, certainly it does. I mean, I think there's a lot of familiarity. Obviously, Kevin Kane, our defensive coordinator, works for Rod at Northern Illinois. And so I think there's some familiarity on both sides. Anytime that you have guys that have worked together, you know, that's nothing new for us. You know, I think this is going to be the fifth out of seven games that, you know, that we're playing against somebody that I've coached with or have known. And so that's college football. I mean, there's familiarity between teams and there's coaching changes, and this kind of thing happens. It's really not that unusual. And so, you know, I think everybody has a plan for it. Everybody prepares for it. I'm sure Temple will will have a plan to adjust what they need to adjust. Certainly we will as well. And you know, at the end of the day, the players decide the game, and those guys, you know, both teams have a lot of good players, and they're going to play hard. And I think in a lot of ways that stuff is you know, gets blown out of proportion.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Coach, thank you for your time as always this morning. We look forward to hearing from you once again next week.
Okay, thank you.